Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents. What happens when things go right with your attitude? What happens when things go wrong? I know an apartment. It was a little dinky apartment. There was nothing about it that you want to write home about. There was nothing about it you want to even take pictures of unless you want to complain. One woman lived in that apartment and it looked like a garage from day one to day, whatever she moved out. The second person moved into that exact same apartment. When we came and looked at it, it looked like something from a designer magazine. We could not believe that that little hole in the wall could look like something so beautiful. Here was the difference. The outlook on life. How did one see her circumstance? How did she react to it? What did she do with it? And how did the other one see her circumstance? How did she react to it? What did she do with it? You can suck your teeth at your life. You can suck your teeth at where you find yourself in life. Or you can beautify, be grateful, and give it your best shot. You determine. You decide how your life is going to taste, feel, and end up by the way you respond to every season in your life. God bless you as you learn this lesson from Devina.
My name is Devina, and Lord had put on my heart was for us to find the beauty and the blessings in all of our situations that we're in and the places that the Lord has set us in right now. For us to get our priorities in the right order, where the Lord is the head of everything, and He is the one that we seek to please, and the one that we seek to be obedient to over ourselves, and over pleasing men, or fulfilling what we want for ourselves sometimes. And the Lord did that through a training that I recently went through. It was like a 21-day challenge where for 21 days, everything that you did was as best as you would give your best in everything that you would do. Like, what, no matter what it was, that you would not do a half-done job or anything. You would do everything you did, no matter what it was, 100%. And the Lord really started to minister to me the scriptures to do all that you do. In Colossians 3:23-24, it says, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as for working for the Lord and not for men. A lot of times when we go throughout our day and we work really hard, maybe sometimes for the people that we work harder for the people that do more for us, like the, or that are more appreciative of what we do. And sometimes it's harder for us to be as productive or as positive or constructive when we're in workplaces where we're not really appreciated or we're not treated fairly. And so our performance at times may not be what it could be because it's a response to how we're being treated, or the same in relationships and how we are in our situation. Well, if I had this, if I had that, if I had that, I could do this much more. I could do that much more. But the Lord put on my heart, Luke 16, verse 10, it said, whoever can be trusted with very little can also be trusted with much. And whoever is dishonest with very little will also be dishonest with much. The other scripture that the Lord put on my heart was the scripture of the servant who buried their treasures in the dirt, or their talents in the dirt. What has God given you? What has God given us? Whether in blessing, whether it's in our relationships, whether it's in our situations, what do we have that we are not seeing the blessing in? Sometimes we might not be happy because the job that we have is challenging or hard, but there's a lot of people out there who don't have even a job. Where there's a lot of people out there doing some really hard labor jobs for change. Not even, you know, they're willing to do. So there's so many blessings that we're blessed with. And we got to remember, no matter what we do, whether it's scrubbing a toilet, whether it's, like it says, whether you're eating, whether you're drinking, all that you do, it's in Colossians 3:17. Everything that we do, it says to do for the glory of God. And that's where sometimes we kind of get set, even upon ourselves. Think of the blessings that the Lord has placed in you, whether you have the ability to sing, whether you have the ability to draw, whether you have the ability to pray for, like, you know, the power of prayer, the power of healing. God has given you patience. God has given you wisdom. Are you using all of that for God's glory? Are you using that to the fullest that you can use it? Are you taking advantage of every opportunity that the Lord has placed before you? Because a lot of times we can be like the Exodus, you know, the Israelites when they were wandering in the desert. It lasted so much more long. Their wandering lasted so much longer because all they could see was or to complain. But if they would only start to focus on all that the Lord has already done, all that they had already been given, they would have been through their wandering so much. They would have been to their promised land so much sooner. And sometimes, especially in America, it's easy for us to not be satisfied with what we have because there's so much advertisement and propaganda trying to get us to want more, and desire more. But the Lord wants us to also remember to have a quiet, peaceful life, where we can be grateful for what we do have. And so that's where the Lord, if we would be, when you wake up, everything that you do that whole day, do it as if God was literally at your house. How much differently would we act if we really had the presence of the Lord before us? How much more would we perform, like in the Bible, let's see, the good servant, Matthew chapter 24 is the example of the good servant versus the bad servant. It says, who is the wise and trusted servant that the master trusts one servant to give the other servants their food at the right time? Who is the one that the master trusts to do that work? When the master comes home and finds that servant doing the work that he gave him, it will be a day of blessing for that servant. What can God trust you with? And think about what the Lord has already trusted you with. He's trusted you with his word and his blessings. He's placed gifts upon your life. And are you using those gifts right now? With even the very little that you may think you have, how much are you doing with that very little that the Lord has given you? And the Lord wants us to realize that even the very little bit that we have, there's a story in 2 Kings chapter 17 about a servant woman, and God sent one of his prophets to a certain place, and the woman had so little of oil and meal that for her and her son, and she was just basically going to prepare her last meal and die is what it was. And God sent the prophet to her. I'm sorry, guys, I'm chopping it up, but the Lord sent the prophet to her and said that if she would take him in, that the Lord would give provision, and they would be sustained by the word of the Lord. And as they stayed, what she already had, what the Lord had already given her, even though it was so little that she was just like, I don't even have enough. This is the last thing that I have before we perish. And if I were to bring another person in this home, like, there's not going to be enough. And that's sometimes where we are, like, we're in these situations and we're in these circumstances, or we have a financial shortage, or we have a sickness coming that somebody something's going on in our family or our relationship, and we just think, like, if I take on another thing, like, there's just no way I'm going to be able to keep this together. But like God said, my grace is sufficient for you. If you would trust in me, and if you would give all of that to me, and do everything that I've called you to do, and use every gift that I've called you to do, and if you do everything with me in mind, then it will be sufficient. And they lasted, and they lasted, and their oil never ran out. They were fed to full every day because they were obedient to the Lord. Their priorities were right. And that's where God says, like, look at what you have. You may think that little bit, but just like Marlene was talking about the mustard seed, just like the Bible says, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can move mountains. You can cast that mountain, say, go into the sea. So it doesn't take much, but a little bit of faith to step and walk in obedience, to say, God, this is all I have, or whatever. And everything that you do, from the time that you get up to the time that you go to sleep, give 100%. Of your day to God, not just 80%, but let's just give 100% with it being God-centered and focused on, okay, Lord, what do you want me to do now? What should I do? Being prayerful, being mindful, being in the Word. And that was the challenge that the Lord placed upon myself. Like, get more serious about it. You got to be about his business. Just like Jesus said, I'm about my Father's business. But are we about our Father's business 100% of the time? Because just like Peter said, we don't know when the time comes. Like, we have to be ready. We have to be prepared. We don't know when the Lord comes. But if we're getting our oil together, we're trimming the lamps and all of these things, then we will be ready, because 100% of our day, 100% of the time, our mindset and our focus is on the blessings that God has already given us. And if we're focused like, well, thank you, Lord, for this sandwich that I have, even though this person over there is eating steak and potatoes for lunch or whatever it is. Thank you, Lord, that I have a crappy job, because that person over there is struggling and their bills are about to get shut off. And Lord, help me to be more grateful. Help me to be more focused on the things that I have, because what little you may have, you can turn that into a blessing if you would only focus on the gratitude and the thankfulness, because there's so many more people in a less that situation than you. There's so many more people maybe not as gifted as you are. There's so many more people that don't even know Christ, that don't even have the opportunity of salvation at this point like you do. That was the challenge that the Lord kind of placed upon me and kind of put on my heart, is for us to be better stewards of the relationships in our life. Whether you're a mother, you're a brother, you're a son, you're an uncle, you're an auntie, how to be an auntie for the Lord, the best that you can do, not just to be an auntie, to be a great auntie because you love that kid, or to be a great mom or a great dad because you just love that kid, because then it's just for your love for that kid, but even that much more for the Lord. I want to be a great mom to give glory to God. I want to be a great worker to give glory to God. I want to be a great custodian to be for the glory of God, because at the end of the day, that's the one who has given us these blessings. That's the one who has orchestrated us into these situations that we are in, and then asking God to help us to see the beauty and the blessings in our situations and our relationships, and how to help us get through those. Because once we start to ask God to see those blessings and to see the beauty in every situation, we're going to continue to keep putting Him as a priority, continue to thank Him, and to make it through. Try to give 100% of your time, like 100%. We can do it to get up and have a paycheck because we need to pay the bills. But if that's the reason why we're getting up and we're going to work, then our reasons and our priorities are wrong, because everything we should do should be for God's glory. Because this life that we have is just a moment. It's going to pass, and we're going to have eternity, and all this is going to be nothing but a memory. So just, I challenge you to give all that you have. Be ready. Be like the wise 10 virgins that were prepared. Jesus is coming back. We don't want to be like the servant in Matthew 24 who didn't care, when didn't know when his master was going to be coming back. He was treating everybody, like I said, beating the other servants, and he did whatever he wanted to do and was caught by surprise when the master came, because Jesus is coming back. And if our hearts and minds are focused on Him, then we'll be ready and we'll be prepared. Thank you, Grace.